All right, I'm up here in Westchester, PA, Friday night for a lockout. So you'll know about the US Express. There he is right there. Went with the mud flap. It wasn't a mud flap hanging, it's a bracket hanging. So I told him I'd have to come back because I'm running behind with all these roll calls. So we're gonna get out of here, unlock this driver, and then get back. I have to go to the shop and see if I got that mud flap bracket. Where's mine? And put a bracket together and then go back to Flying J and install it. So the other one, the one over with the no start, that one turned out to have a starter issue. I looked over at the starter connections and the solenoid's been fried. So I don't know if they were disconnecting the batteries to replace the starter or what, but they said they had no record of anybody else working on the truck. So get him unlocked, and then once I get that mud flap bracket together, I go back behind Jay, I'll record that video too. So
how you doing?
What's up, man? Rub up against it.
Rub up against it?
Yeah, I can't just hook it. That's why I put the rubber piece down there. Come on. There we go.
Damn.
If I push down, if I push down, I'll lock it again.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Get a little out of there. There we go.
All right, let me get my pad, get some info, you'll be ready to roll, okay?
All right,
sounds good.
Thank you.
All right. Lock that side of the door. All right, so I got him back in his truck. Once I get this all put away, if I head back to Elkton, like I said, see if I got that bracket, put it together, and then head back to that US Express call. Install a new mud flap bracket with mud flap. So they just said it. I tried calling the driver a few times, he wouldn't answer his phone when I was on the way there. And then he finally came out. So told the company and him I'd have to come back to it because I'm running behind on these road calls. I'm late for this one, this lockout here. The first two wouldn't have been no big deal if it was just a simple jump start and a simple mud flap. But it turned out to be more than that. Maybe five. this your only stop?
Huh?
Is this your only stop?
Yeah, I got two more yet. Yeah.
Okay. I got held up. The other two, I told Jay behind, it'd be close to 2 hours, maybe less.
Right.
Because I already had one ahead of them, but it was nothing simple.
Right.
Yeah.
I called back and I'm like, yeah, I just want to make sure somebody's still coming.
Yeah, no,
good. I got my clock running out, you know what I mean?
Right, well, because the first one I was at and I had one ahead of them, it was supposed to be just a jump start. Somebody took the batteries apart. Couldn't figure out why. Got it together, found out the starter was bad.
Yeah.
Tried to call a driver for the mud flap. They said, just the mud flap. No, the whole mud flap bracket's mangled. Never answered his phone. And then when he did come out and I got in touch with him, I said, listen, because he says he's going to be there for 10 hours. So I said, well, look, I said, I'll have to come back. I said, because I'll be running late for my next call.
Yeah, right.
So,
hey,
have a good one, man. Door again. All right, so that's gonna do it for this one. Like I said, once I get back to the shop, and I'm pretty sure we got that bracket. If not, I can make a bracket, cut to fit, and then put a mud flap on it. So yeah, so once I get back there and get that done, then there'll be another video on me going back to Flying J to do the mud flap bracket. So all right, so I'll see you on the next one.